Okay, family, so I want to welcome you to Jittering on Hypes Media. My name is Sir Isaac. Last week, we had a wonderful session with one of the renowned resource personnel in Ghana by name Pastor Ni Sam Nunu. And he was a blessing to us. I believe you enjoyed our convo. Today, we are blessed to have him in the studio once again with us to discuss one or two issues in the gospel space. So without much ado, let's take a very quick short break. When we come back, we'll just introduce our guest once again and then begin the conversation with our guest. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back shortly. Okay, so family, you are welcome back once again. My guest today on Jittering Show is none other but Pastor Ni Sam
Chairman,
Nunu.
chairman, chairman. It's good to be back here again.
Oh, we are so blessed to have you in the studio
Thank
once
you.
again.
Thank you. It's good to be here
And
again.
thank you for always being this with us.
I'll be coming here. I'll be
Oh.
coming here. So I think we'll be having this more often. All
Thank you.
right.
Thank you. Thank you. So last week we had a very nice convo on the topic copyright and other related
Right.
issues. But today, I saw the comments and then the observations, everything surrounding the topic
Right.
online, and I realized people were really blessed with whatever we discussed.
Wow, that
But
was
today I want us to do something or talk about covers, song
right,
covers.
right, right.
So, folks, I want to do something about song covers. When we say song covers, what is really song? How do we do a song cover, and how do we go about it? Is this something that is done? Is this something that must be carefully looked at before we handle it, or you go into the studio to record a song, someone's song? What is the procedure? How do we go about it?
I think I told somebody last week that every music or creative person, especially music, would love to hear their music go far. So it is a wrong school of thought to think that people don't want you to do covers of their
Cover
song.
song.
Because mind you, if the song goes far, the person too is going far. So every creative will want that their music piece will go far. But then the thing is that you have to go through the right channel of doing it because, after all, it's the person's hard work, the person's sweat, the person went through certain procedures to get their song out
Done.
there.
Okay.
So, if you want to do a cover of their song, then it's appropriate that you go through the right
The right
channel,
channel. Okay.
especially if whatever that you're putting your song would have to then deal with commercial purposes.
Purposes. Okay.
Then it is very, very important that you get in touch with them. And covers, especially in our little space in Ghana, I see that people do covers, covers, covers. But speaking to few people, I've realized that people do it for the fun of, okay, I'm a musician, I'm doing a cover. So, and because it is gospel, forgetting that in as much as it's a gospel, there's an industry part of it. And people will not see things the way you see
You see
things.
things
And once we are in this world and there are certain laws binding us,
binding us
it's important that we follow
the
those
right
laws.
procedures. Okay.
So covers, like I said, is good to do. But if you want to do a cover, there are certain do's
And
and
don'ts.
certain don'ts. So these are the things we need to know before doing a cover.
Okay, but what is the first stage one must first look at before do a cover of someone's song?
Okay, so before you do a cover, it's important to note that it's not your song in the first place. So there are two types of licenses that we have in doing a cover. So you have the mechanical license that deals with only audios.
Audios.
So if you want to put out a cover of someone's song in just an audio format, but in our space, everybody's doing video, and they don't even know that there are three types of licenses in doing covers. Mm. So there's mechanical license that has to do with only audios. So for example, I want to put out an audio slide of someone's cover.
Okay.
I would have to get, go and do, even an audio slide, I would still categorize that as a video because it's in a form of a motion.
Yeah.
But if you want to do just audio, an audio file, you have to go and seek for mechanical license. Mm. But if you now want to move from audio and go to put it out on YouTube, then you have to go for synchronization license.
Yeah.
So that, because mind you that now in our system, everything is becoming digital.
Yeah.
So if you're putting a cover of someone's song out there, some of these platforms like YouTube, they have mechanisms in place to know that this song is from someone. And in order not to get a copyright strike, just get the right licenses. If it is audio you are doing, just get the mechanical so that the author knows that, okay, this person, so-and-so, is doing a cover of my song. And mind you that, like I said from the beginning, every artist would want their song to go far.
Mm-hmm.
The only reason why they're going to have an issue with you is when you don't seek their permission and when they don't know. So if you want to do an audio cover, go for a mechanical license. If you want to do a video cover, upload it on YouTube, wherever it is, just seek for a synchronization cover or license.
Also, before you continue, someone may also say that, oh, I did a cover, the song is good. It's the same song compared to the original song, but the rhythm is different. Does that one also qualify? Must the person still go ahead to contact the original owner?
Right. You see, the term cover in the first place means that you are acknowledging that you are doing, let's say, a rendition of someone's song.
Or a remix of someone's song.
So, first and foremost, the foundation has been set that you are doing somebody's song. So, then it's important that you seek their permission.
Mm.
Whether you are changing the rhythm, whatever it is, once you are saying you are doing a cover, you have acknowledged the fact that it is someone's piece you are using.
Mm.
So, once you have acknowledged that, you have to go through the right channel. You just have to go through it.
Mm.
So it's not about changing the rhythm. No. A cover is a cover. It's your rendition of someone's piece. How you sing it, whether I want to fly, jump. The thing is that let the person know that I'm doing a cover of your song. So in case you see it out there, you are aware.
Okay. I've seen a couple of people do covers of other people's songs.
Mm.
And then they contact their management, but the amount of money they mention that before you post my material out there, you need to settle up with this particular amount. Is this something that you think we should encourage?
Hmm. You see, I've heard of this thing several times. And I always say that ignorance about the law is not an excuse. All right. And I will say that there is a reason why there is a music body that governs our music space, which is GAMRO.
Yeah.
Right. Now, ideally, if the author of the song registered with GAMRO, if you are in US, you register with the US copyright. If you are in UK, I think you register with PSR.
Yeah, yeah.
If you are in Canada, some kind, you register with SOCAN. So with Ghana, ours is GAMRO.
Yeah.
If the author of the song went through the right channel of registering with GAMRO, and you want to seek license, where do you go to? You go to GAMRO. They give you the rate. When you pay for that, it comes to the author. It comes to the utter.
But before you continue, in this scenario, you realize that most of our artists are not registered with GAMRO. So how do you go about that?
You see, the thing is that when you have a music piece out there and you're not registered with the copyright body, let me just chip in this. There's something called the Berne Convention. BERNE. The Berne Convention has over 181 countries.
Mm.
in a sense that if, for example, like we initially discussed that we talk about the diaspora in music, if, for example, you fall within the Benin Convention, and I travel to any country within the 181 countries, and I have copyright here, it covers me because I am within the Benin countries.
Okay.
I don't know if you get my point.
Yeah,
I
get it.
The Benin countries. So if I am a songwriter and I have a song out there and it is not registered with the recognized body of copyright, your song remains a public domain song.
Mm.
Because when you register with the recognized body in Ghana, God being so good, we are part of the Benin Convention.
Yeah.
So automatically, when you move out of your space to another country, you are still recognized.
Mm.
So then, if any artist is saying that I am a musician and I am doing my songs and I've not registered with the copyright law in Ghana, your song remains a public domain song. And in the long run, for example, assuming that Kwame Mickey was not registered with GAMRO or any copyright body, he could not have made these allegations. And remember, in our first session, I said that copyright begins when you have the idea. The reason why you're going to register is to defend. Uh-huh. So you having the idea is good. But when someone takes the idea, you can't defend it because you have not registered. So if you are not registered with a copyright body of a nation, you are a creative, you do literary works, you do artistic works, and you have not registered the thing you're doing with the recognized copyright system of the nation.
Okay.
That you say Uye Jumajai. Because then you are doing your works, but in the place of defense, if someone takes now this is the amazing thing about copyright. So for example, assume that I wrote a song and I never registered the song. You heard me sing the song at a program. I've not registered the song. Mind you, I said copyright starts from the birth of the idea.
Yeah.
So I own the song, but I don't have the legal backing to defend that I have the song.
Own.
You heard the song, you went to record the song, did a copyright, you are going to own it. So it's important that, yes, you have the idea. You have the idea of the thing. Now, go through the channel that helps you protect your idea. So yes, having the registration of a copyright backing is very, very important in the area of your protection of your idea. So if you are a creative, you don't have a copyright backing you, you're in for trouble.
So it goes hand in hand. The one who does the cover suffers, and then the originator of the property also suffers.
So this thing is very important. Now the thing is that it will be more advantageous to the one doing the cover.
Mm.
Assuming that I've done a song, da-na-se, and me, the author, have not gone through the right channel to obtain copyright for my creative works, and you pick up the same song and you do a cover
and it blows.
One, I can't accuse you that you stole it because I don't have the legal document.
Ownership. Okay.
Because if you take it to court, mind you that the court is going to ask GAMRO that they should provide
them
the proof
data. Okay.
Of registration. Now, we ask, okay, Mr. Sir Isaac, GAMRO, Rex Omar comes. You don't have, you are not recorded in their system. So in the first place, you have lost the case. Now, it's going to be more deadly when you pick the song and then you register with GAMRO, the same song. Now, automatically, in as much as I may have birthed the idea, you own the copyright. So if I go and put out an audio or a video out there, I'm going to get a copyright strike.
Let's look at it this way. Assuming you create an art,
right?
You don't go through the right procedures to register it. I do a cover, or I do another rendition of it, and I realize the original art was not registered. but I go ahead and register. Is this something that can be done? Can Gamro still go ahead and register me since the original act has not been registered?
Okay, so I want us to read something to the audience so that I don't want them to be like I'm seeing it from my mind.
Yeah.
Now, what is copyright? Copyright is a legal concept, the word legal.
Mm.
A legal concept that gives the creators of original works exclusive rights to their use and distribution. So one, it is illegal. So whatever you are doing in the creative space must have a legal backing. That gives you what? Exclusive right. Now, what is that exclusive right? You can reuse the work, distribute, and produce the work. Now, if I have the work, but I don't have the legal concept to give me the, because the legal backing gives you the exclusive right.
Yeah.
So legal backing equals exclusive right. So assuming that I have the idea, but I don't have the legal concept, I am denied the exclusive right. Right. I don't know if you get it.
I get it.
Yeah, so I have the song. I have the song. But I have not registered the song piece with Gamro. I still don't have the legal concept to obtain the exclusive right.
So it means you'll be denied that right.
Right, I'm going to be denied. So if you, assuming that I came here, I was singing a song, you liked it. All right?
Mm-hmm.
And the fact that people know it, people have heard the song, that doesn't know. Because the funny thing is that, you may be singing a song, people know, okay, it is Isaac who is singing the song.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is that, does Gamro know that, you own mm-hmm. the piece? Because mind you, first session I said that copyright starts when you birth the idea.
The idea.
But obtaining registration is what gives you defense that you own the work. So if you don't get the registration, you are denied exclusive right. So yes, the idea is from you, but it is the legal backing that can defend you.
So legal ownership is very key.
It's very key in the area of copyright infringement and theft. I get it.
Right. I believe my audience are also following it.
Right. So for example, I buy a phone.
Mm.
I buy a phone. Now, anytime you buy a phone does not come with a lock.
Mm-hmm.
So I can just pick it up and use it. Anybody can pick it up, go through your files. Now, what is going to prevent a third party from going through is when you do what? Add a password. So now the password becomes the copyright you have obtained.
Mm-hmm.
So it gives you exclusive right to the phone to open it, go to anywhere you want without, you know, the third party having access. So that's a clear example. So copyright is very important, because without that, you can't have the legal backing, one. Two, you can't have the exclusive right. That's the most dangerous thing. And in our system, we have a lot of people who are into the creative space and they don't have copyright.
One interesting thing is that you hear of some songs online and you ask yourself, these songs, they are real original songs out there. So how were they able to, even in the first place, put their songs out there on the distribution platforms?
Mm-hmm.
How did those distribution platforms allow the songs to be out there? I don't know whether you get what I'm saying.
I'm trying to get a question.
Come. You see, you may have a song A
mm-hmm.
by, let's say, you. You right, right, a song yeah. A.
Right.
It has been registered, copyrighted, everything.
Right.
And distributed on all the digital platforms online.
Right.
Another party, let's say party B, will do a cover of the song, upload it on these same distribution platforms, and it will be allowed to go through without following the proper procedures. How are these things done? Why do these distribution platforms allow certain things to happen? Because that is what brings most of the confusions.
That is a very good question. It's a question I've been waiting for someone to ask me for a very long time. Now, the thing is that these platforms, in as much as they are platforms, they have human beings operating these platforms. One, before that, they have been putting mechanisms to, you know,
check
these things. But mind you, the person who created the platform is not a Ghanaian. To know all your three songs, at least it can identify your common English songs.
Yeah.
Now, the question is that, in fact, there are people in our space who don't know that there's something called YouTube Content ID. So you can be on YouTube and you not have a content ID. I hope you are getting, because it's what that identifies your content. So being on YouTube, oh, I'm on YouTube, I have 10,000 followers, but you have a content ID. Because if you are mentioning an ID is for the for short identification.
Yeah.
So your content must have an identification. So one of the things is that most people are putting out their songs out there on YouTube, especially, and they don't have a content ID. They don't have it. Now, two, it is also important to note that if, like I said, it's a mechanism. It is still growing. It is not everything that it can know. And the thing is that YouTube gives you room. That if I see that my music piece A has been done by another person and it didn't go to the right channel, report it.
Yeah.
So they have a channel. So the thing is that you also have a role to play. And getting them to know that someone has stolen your song. That's one of the things you want. So one, get know that if you're on YouTube especially, get a content ID. So that all your content will have identification.
Yeah.
Then two, how do you call it? If you see that someone has stolen a piece of your song,
what you can report it.
Because YouTube is not God.
To know everything.
No. Even ChatGPT, there are certain things when you ask ChatGPT, it will tell you searching from Bing. Even ChatGPT, they ask from outside sources. How much more YouTube? So if there's something that blows your mind or you don't understand it, or someone has done something in the area of your content, report it. Because day in, day out, our phones, especially for iPhones, and they bring updates.
Yeah.
So the system too is being worked on. YouTube is not perfect. So they are working on their system. They're working on their system. There are people that when they put out an audio, YouTube blocks it.
Yeah. Yeah.
That should tell you that
artists you dare not
you
put
dare
their
not.
Audios.
You dare not. And sometimes too, by reason of popularity.
Yeah.
By reason of popularity too. Now, let me tell you something. In as much as Michael Jackson is late, you cannot. You cannot. Even though he's registered, you cannot. So the question is that you and I, that we are not popular. You want to... Oh. So you have to go through that. Because you don't even have the name in the first place. So if you don't have the name, you can go for the first two options. Get a YouTube content ID. Or if you see someone infringing on your piece, just report.
I guess sometimes they do that to try and test the system if it's properly working. And then they also see whether they can beat
the
system.
You know one thing too about YouTube is that they have also acknowledged the fact that there are days they even copyright strike people.
Yeah.
And then based on the similarity of
content.
Then sometimes if you write to them, they take it back.
Yeah.
So even the system, sometimes it triggers. It will self-trigger when you see some content that are similar.
Mm-hmm. Now they are so much hard on content creators.
Right.
The similarities, the framework,
right,
the video, everything is taken into consideration.
Right. That should tell you, because YouTube was not like that before.
Yeah.
Now it's getting upgraded daily. So especially if you want to go into content creation or you want to do a cover, especially if you are staying within this discussion,
yeah,
want to do a cover, please just go through the right channel. I don't want to mention any, but my mother, I think you spoke to her last week. Somebody did a channel. So let me pan up with my book cover, left, right, center. that channel was blocked. It was blocked. You cannot. So you see, the thing is that just go to the right channel. Because at the end of the day, if you go to the right channel and the plus comes, you get the name.
Yeah.
If you don't, now this is a disadvantage. Okoboka. Ofaka akosti di okwa. You wasted your time. Then you're going to close down your channel. So let's go through the right process.
It's sad because most of the original content creators go through a lot to make sure to get their content
right
online. So right, when we see covers of these materials without going through the right procedures, I think it's something
right
which is not right good, and we must all do our best to right follow the right procedures right to make sure that the right things are done.
Exactly.
Yeah. Exactly. Also, thank you so much for being
you're
a blessing
welcome
to us
you're
today.
You're
any final words before we leave?
I will say that, especially to my music people, doing a cover is good. Doing a cover is good. And then when we say a cover, it is not just about a music piece.
Mm.
If it has got to do with artistic works.
Work.
Okay. It has got to do with literary works. So if you have to do a cover of someone's work, please do well to go through the right channel.
Mm.
If it's an audio cover you want to do, go get your mechanical license. If you want to do a video, do your synchronization license, and then you are good to go. Now, in fact, in our churches, every Sunday we do covers. Yes. In our churches, every Sunday we are doing covers. But you see,
no proper procedures are followed.
Oh yes, but in certain countries like this,
yeah,
we have the, I think I spoke about the blanket license,
yeah,
where it covers the churches that you see, because every Sunday you can't tell me that there has
you
a church. So there are systems that are put in place to make sure that churches and certain organizations that play certain songs out in the public, they are paying certain licenses. They make sure that we follow certain things. So I think we should get the right procedures done. If you want to do a cover, just go through it the right way. Because mind you, the Atta went through a whole lot of struggle. Some of them, it took them 5 years to write one song. They want to use 30 minutes to do a cover. And on top of it, you are going to blow. Now, this is what pains me. Even if they didn't come at you, you put the song out on YouTube, or you went to minister somewhere, someone blessed you, 10,000. Look for the, you don't even look for the people to say, God bless you. You chop all the money. Now that's the most, that is so painful that you put it out there. The person said, "Oh, assume you can't." The person did not talk. At least wisdom demands that
you go and bless the person. Oh, mommy, daddy, I did a cover of your song, and out of that, I'm getting shoes.
At least the person will say that. Oh, for this reason. In fact, do all my songs. But our people too, and you see one more thing too. When you do a cover and you acknowledge a person, especially when you acknowledge them and there is a money return, please don't let your acknowledgement end just by words.
Okay.
Because if it was just acknowledgement, then the money should not come. But something came in return for you. So find a way and go and give them a blessing. It's a good sign. So this is what I'll say. And if you are going to listen, you're going to go far. And our new crops of artists too, people are, and it's like covers become like the foundation for your blow. Covers become like the foundation for your blow. So if you want to do a cover, go through the right channel.
Okay. Before we close, finally, let me ask you this. Can Gamro also alert the original content creator or the one who bet the idea, registered the song, that party A or B has done a rendition or a cover of your song?
That's can be possible maybe in some years to come. Because then we now have to put in systems. We now have to put in systems to know that this and this, because we are in a digital space.
Yeah.
So if Gambo would have to now put in this into their system too, then they have to really, really invest into that. Because it will not come that easy.
Easy. Okay.
It is possible, but not possible. And if they really want to do that, then I think Gambo would have to then partner, is it NCA? I think what NCA, Channel of Communication or something.
Yeah, National Communication Authority.
Yes. Yeah. So they have to partner with NCA, partner with all the radio stations, partner with this media. They have to then partner with YouTube. Which is going to take a lot of time, a lot of money, but it is possible.
Yeah,
it's possible. So Gamro now cannot do it. It's going to take years of work, integrations, none of that.
Okay.
Yeah. But I think in other countries, you cannot.
Mm.
Oh, you cannot. In other countries, you cannot.
We'll get there. I know it's not going to be that easy, but gradually we are going to get there.
That's true.
Guys, this has been G Terrain on Hypes Media with your brother and your friend, Sir Isaac. I believe you have been blessed by the things we have discussed here today on this particular segment in the studio of Hypes Media. I believe and hope that you take into consideration with some of these things to make sure to do the right thing so that you don't find yourself in a position that so let's do our best, let's follow the right procedures and make sure we get the right things done. And I believe as we do that, we'll be smiling. So that, thank you so much for doing the watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I will also urge you to press the bell notification so that anytime we upload a new video, you also get a chance to do the watching right here in the studio of Hypes Media with us. Thank you so much. I will see you again in another episode. God bless you all.